A major bridge in Baltimore has collapsed after being struck by a cargo ship. Eamon Javers has the latest for us from the scene. Eamon.
Wilf, that's right. Officials here just wrapping up a press conference over the past couple of minutes and giving us new details now on the terrifying moments just before the bridge collapsed at about 1:30 a.m. this morning in the dark of night. Officials saying that the crew of the ship, this nearly 1,000-foot-long commercial vessel, the Dolly, a Singapore-flagged vessel, were able to issue a mayday call just before the impact, and they were able to transmit information to officials here at the Port of Baltimore that they had lost propulsion. And that was enough notice, Governor Wes Moore said just moments ago, for crews on either side of the bridge to block traffic. Whatever early morning traffic was already moving, they said they were able to stop cars from getting onto the bridge, and that may have saved quite a few lives, as there were not a lot of vehicles on the bridge at the moment it went down. Tragically, though, there was a construction crew on the bridge at the time that it collapsed. The construction crew was simply filling potholes on the overnight shift. They say there were 8 people who were on the bridge when it went down. 6 of those are still being looked for. Search and rescue crews, they say, are on the scene and continue to search for those victims. No word yet on the fate of those 6. 2 others were rescued. 1 has been hospitalized. 1 was remarkably able to walk away on his own power in the wake of this disaster. So a real brush there for that individual. But 6 still unaccounted for, and they are continuing to look. I asked Governor Wes Moore of Maryland just moments ago what his prognosis is for reopening shipping here at the Port of Baltimore, if he has any early indication of how long commerce is going to be stopped at this major East Coast port. He said it's simply too early to say that right now. He said their focus is on search and rescue at this minute. But he did also say, guys, that he was able to rule out at least one potential factor here in causing this incident. Take a listen to the governor of Maryland just a few moments ago.
We are still investigating what happened, but we are quickly gathering details. The preliminary investigation points to an accident. We haven't seen any credible evidence of a terrorist attack.
So at this point, this just seen as a tragic accident here at the Port of Baltimore. But as you guys know, such a major hub for commerce and business up and down the East Coast, major port here for automobiles, the largest port on the East Coast for automobile arrivals in the United States. More than 800,000 cars and light trucks arrived at this port in 2023, the 13th year that it was a leading port for automobiles here on the East Coast. So it gives you a sense of the scale of the economic impact that we're now going to start to see. The governor said at this point it's going to be an all of society effort to get this bridge out of the water and to reconstruct. He said they're going to reconstruct better than before, and he said they're going to reconstruct in a way that preserves the memory of those who have been impacted. Too early to say what the ultimate casualty count here will be, because search and rescue is still going on. But at this point, they are saying that they are going to rebuild here in Maryland. Back over to you guys.